Welcome to my English class, English Grammar, Class 9, Chapter 7, Countables and Uncountables. We have already discussed about nouns, the naming words. In this class, we shall discuss about countable nouns and uncountable nouns.
Hello students, let us discuss countable nouns and uncountable nouns. We know nouns, the naming words, some of them are count nouns and others are uncount nouns. Okay, so what is a noun? So nouns are the naming words. A noun is a word used as the name of a person, place or thing. You take the example, Ashok was a great king. Here Ashok is the name of a person. So Ashok is a noun. So Puri is famous for Lord Jagannath. Puri is the name of a place. We know, so it is a noun. And iron is a heavy metal. We know iron here is a thing. It's visible. We can see. So it is a thing. So it is a noun. Honesty is the best polish. We can say that honesty is here invisible. We can't see. We can't touch. But we can only feel. So this is also a noun. So what is a noun? A noun is a word used as the name of a person, place or thing. So, we can classify nouns into two. Some of them are countables and others are uncountables. Countable nouns are the nouns which can be counted. And they have two verbs, singular and plural. For example, boy, boys, toy, toys, tooth, teeth, man, men, girls, girls, like this. And uncountable nouns are nouns which cannot be counted. Nouns which do not usually go with an, one, two, many, etc. are uncount nouns or uncountable nouns. Okay. Example, water, we can't count. Milk, we can't count. Truth, we can't count. These are the examples of uncountable nouns. Singular countable nouns and uncountable nouns take singular verb forms. For example, this tree grows well. The tree is here singular, countable noun. Water is essential for life. Water is uncountable so noun. So it carries the verb is singular. But plural countable nouns take plural verb forms. For example, these trees grow well. Here tree is the plural countable noun. So here verb is grow. And it takes the plural verb form. Okay, so singular countable nouns and their plural forms. So we know how to make singular nouns to plural nouns. Most of the singular countable nouns can be made plural by adding s to them. Boy, boys. Goat, goats. Cow, cows. Tree, trees. Flute, flutes. Bed, beds. Pen, pens. Pencils, pencils. We can make plural by simply adding s. And in case we add es, when the singular countable noun ending in s, ss, tch, sh or x to make them plural. For example, glass. Here the word begins with the ss. So we say glasses and watch. Watches, bench, benches, and this, you see, and this word, singular noun, ends with SH. So, we use ES, this S. Fox, the word ends with X. So, we say foxes. Okay. So, some singular noun, countable nouns, ending in Y, with a consonant before it, we replace Y. With the IES to make them plural. Okay. Country, you see, the singular noun ends with Y. And it is before Y, a consonant sound R is there. So we have to replace Y with the IES. Okay. So country, countries. Party, parties. Lady, ladies. Body, bodies. Okay, so you see another example, and in case of nouns ending with F or AP, we usually replace F or AP with VES to make them plural. How? Take the example, scarf. You see, AP is there, the word ends with F. So we have to replace F with the VS. Cup, cups. Leaf, leaves. Wipe, F-E. Wipe the word or noun ends with F-E. So we have to replace F-E with V-E-S. Wipe, wipes. Knife, knives. Some nouns ending in O take S. Some others take ES to become plural. You see, photo, photos. Piano, pianos. Musical instrument is there. Technical instrument is there. But mango and potato fruits, we use ES. Mango, mangoes. Potato, potatoes. Here, ES. Here, only S. Difference is there. It's natural, it's artificial. And a piano is musical instrument. So some nouns having OO in between, between, we change OO to E to make them plural. So how? Tooth, teeth. Foot, feet. Goods, geese, like this. Some nouns do not change their forms into plurals. You know, sheep. It's singular. And in plural also we use sheep. In singular we use deer. In plural we also use deer. And you see some singular countable nouns along with their plural nouns will change. How? Man, men. Complete different changes there. Child, children. Mouse, mice. Ox, oxen, like this. So, okay. So, we know how to make singular nouns to plurals by adding yes, yes, like this. And some countable nouns always go in pairs and take plural verbs, like trousers. They always go in pairs. My trousers are new. As they go always in pairs, they take plural verb. They are plural. The scissors need sharpening. These binoculars have powerful lenses. But we can make it singular with use of a pair. A pair of goggles, a pair of trousers, a pair of binoculars, a pair of jeans like this. A pair of goggles is useful in summer. So, these are the pair words. Those always carry their plural and take a plural verb forms. Like the other, this type of nouns, jeans, pajamas, glasses, spectacles, etc. Where are my glasses? Like this. And let us discuss collective nouns. Collective nouns refer to a group of people. If they consider the group as a one body, we use a singular verb with them. If we see the body as a separate individuals, we use a plural verb. For example, our cricket team has won many trophies. How the team here is taken as a singular, single group. So here, team is singular. We know team is a collective now when it is taken as singular. When it is taken as a group, as one, or a single group, it takes singular form. And the team have not prepared themselves as well. Here team here refers to the members of the team, the players of the team. So, it is here, it takes the plural verb. The team have not. Individual members of the team. Okay. Likewise, the committee. The committee has submitted its report. All the members having the same opinion. That means committee taken as a whole. So, it is singular. And the committee have differed in their opinions. Here, committee refers to the members having separate opinions. Okay, so other verbs, other nouns like the are example class. The class is silent, yet the class is taken as a singular. And the class are good cricketers, the students of the class. So some other collective nouns of this type are crowd, public, government, council, army, company, family, and audience, like audience, etc. And but nouns like police, people, cattle, they are always plural. Some nouns are there, they are always in plural and they take plural verbs. For example, the cattle are grazing. The police have caught the thief. People do not like dishonest politicians. Some other nouns are used in plural forms and take plural verbs, such as clothes, belongings, contents, earnings, surroundings, savings, etc. They always take plural verb forms. Okay. So we have already discussed countables. Let us discuss uncountable nouns. We know uncountable nouns. We do not use a, an, several, a few, a number, numerals like one, two, etc. before uncountable nouns. Okay. And uncountables mostly go with the singular verbs. We have to keep these two points in our mind. We can use certain other words before them. What we can use before uncountable nouns? We cannot use a, and we cannot use several, a few, one, two, three, like this. But what we can use before uncountable nouns? We can. I do not like milk. Here, milk is taken as general, so there is no need of any determiner. There is the milk I kept here. Here, the is there. This is article, and the specific reference is there. So, definite article D can be used before uncountable with the meaning the in specific reference. Okay. This is my milk, but that is yours. Here, my is used before milk, and it is possessive. So, we can use also possessive before uncountable nouns. Please boil this or that milk. Here, this, that are demonstratives. We can use demonstratives. This, that, these, those before uncountable nouns. You will find some, a lot of, a little, no milk here in affirmative sentences. We can use. In a negative or interrogative sentences or question sentences, we can use much and any. For example, there is much to not much or any milk in the glass. So we can usually use much, any in negative or interrogative course sentences. But some, a lot of, little, a little, a few, no are used in affirmative sentences. Okay. So some commonly used uncountable nouns are examples: advice, accommodation, equipment, glass, leisure, scenery, hair, lock, traffic, baggage, health, machinery, homework, money, phone, information, news, furniture, knowledge, progress. These are the examples of uncountable nouns. So uncountable nouns ending in S, you see, they look like countables, but they are uncountable because they end with S. There are certain nouns ending in S, they look like countables, but they are uncountable nouns. And go with singular verbs. They are mainly names of some diseases, subject of the study and sports activities. Example, mathematics is my favorite subject. You see, mathematics is a subject here. The noun ends with S. It looks like plural, but it is singular. Diabetes, the name of a disease. It ends with S, but it is singular. Diabetes is a common disease. Gymnastics, it is a sport. They begins with S, but it is singular. Carries the singular tense, singular verb. Gymnastics is good for health. Other uncountables of this type are diseases like mumps, measles, rabies, inches, and scabies. Subjects of study, physics, statistics, economics, politics, electronics, sports activities like athletics, sports, billiards, saddles, cars. These are the examples of the uncountable nouns. So we can also make uncountable nouns countable with the help of a bar of soap, a bottle of milk, a block of ice, a grain of wheat, a glass of water, a tin of jam, a piece of advice, a sheet of paper, like this. But some countable nouns have different meanings in their plural forms. When they are in singular form, they have the real meaning. And when they are in plural forms, they have different meanings. We usually do not make uncountable nouns or use uncountable nouns in plural forms. But sometimes some uncountable nouns are there. When they are in plural forms, meaning difference is there. For example, sand. We need sand and stone to build houses. Here material is no in adopius. Children are playing in the sands of the river. Here sands means large areas of sand. Other example, water. Give me a glass of water. Here water is liquid material, so. And waters here means we swam in the waters of Chilika. Waters here means a large water body. Work is your ship. Physical or mental labor. But works here is a different factory. I have got a job in a steel works. Works here factory. Not labor. Workshop. Glass we know. You can see through glass. As transparent material. But glasses means spectacles. You need glasses for your eyes. Tin is a useful material, metal here. Tins, put the biscuits in the tins, tin container. Okay. Some nouns can be used as uncountables, countables, or uncountables with different meanings. Other examples, you see paper. When you use it uncountable, I would like to buy some paper, meaning paper. But when it is used as a countable, the meaning different. I am going to buy a paper here means the newspaper. Iron, the pillar is made of iron. Iron here is the metal. He is pressing his clothes with an iron. Here an iron is an instrument. And land, farmers work on the land. Ground used for farming. India is our native land. Here land is a state. Okay. You see, I think you have discussed countables and uncountables. And I think you have a clear-cut idea. Let us do the activity. Activity 1, fill in the blanks with suitable words from the bracket. This scissors, dash sharpening. You see, need sharpening. Why? We know scissors is a pair of, he always go in a pair, so it is plural and it takes plural verb form. Okay. I have dash knowledge of computer. You see, I have no knowledge of computer. Why? Because knowledge is uncountable. We can't use many before an uncountable. And we use no. I have no knowledge of a computer. Okay. The furniture in the room is new. Why? Because we know furniture look like is plural, but furniture is singular. And it takes a singular verb. The police have arrested the thief. We know police is always plural. So it takes plural verb. The news is true. Though the noun ends with S, but it is singular. So, the news is true. And please give my regards to your parents. Your regards is singular, it is uncountable. So, it is used. I got a little help from him. We can't use a few because help is uncountable. Before uncountable, we can use a little, not a few. I got a little help from him. Okay. I have got a job in a steel works. Here works means factory. So we can't say steel work. Okay. I want a dash shop. We can use bar of shop. Why bar of shop? Because it is make it to use as countable. They have not left dash work for me. Much work for me. Why? More work is uncountable. And you see, this is a negative sentence. We know in negative sentences, we can use much any. Not a lot of. A lot of in affirmative sentences. I think you have got a clear idea about the countables and uncountables. Okay, thank you very much.